Hello guys, I am with Tero and we are just recording the lesson number 3 of today for our level up session, our KOF tutorial. Call it as you want. Only a second. There you go. So the first video that we did together was about defense and blocking and movement and you know bare basics. Second video I've done by myself last time was about meter and you know how much meter to use, how much meter each character has, and so on, blah blah blah. Today we're going to talk finally about attack, because everyone wants to press buttons, right? So first of all, we have pretty big difference in knockdowns. First thing that you might want to know, right? Hard knockdown, if the adult tries to recover, you can't. Soft knockdown, you can recover and you will always recover with a rollback. There's no roll forward in the game. Now, this is very important because, of course, it changes the way you set up your own attack. Now, KOF is a game where high lows are pretty strong, but with decent reaction and decent experience, you can block on reaction if you try hard enough. However, this is broken by many things. In my case, with my character, I don't have a common throw. So for example, if I do that and he block and I see that he keeps blocking, actually, I just can do that and then do a common throw. However, with my character, if I have an overhead, I can go into true pressure and so on. And every character pretty much has frame traps. So if they don't press a button after blocking, you can counter it and you can confirm. And also, there's a guard crush meter. That means that if I keep on just, you know, doing the same thing over and over and over and over again, at a certain point they're gonna stop blocking. They're gonna even more punish. This is generally your aggression. However, in this game it's also very strong to just throw lights out, as we have seen in the defense. So after blocking a jump in, oops, I'm sorry. If he throws the light, standing light, yeah, after blocking, I have to read it. So can't read it, right? Oops. See? But if I want to jump again, I'll be fucked up. Because a light is pretty riskless. So what you can do, oops, again, stay out of the range, knowing the button that they're gonna press, stay out of the range and with punish, like in any other game. Not really so common in KOF, but it can be done. And also it can lead to big damage, as in other games, so... Oops, again. Yeah, you see why it's not so common, it's quite hard. And so on. So... Pretty much your attack, like when you're not in, when you're in, because when you're not in, then you have different approaches. Your attack will be based on high, low, empty into throw, delayed buttons to catch them mashing, and keeping an eye on the guard bar in case they have excessive guard. Of course, on the other side, they can always like CD blowback, you know, guard cancel CD, guard cancel rolls, and so on. We spoke about this last time, and I spoke about it also briefly in the last video as well. So there is ways, there are ways to get out of pressure. All of them are baitable. So if you do guard cancel blowback after blocking my jump, yeah, see, that's what happens. But if you're low enough, and if you're fast enough, because I suck. Oh, I actually got fucked up for the. Hold on. Yeah, get some meter. Put everything to limitless. You can go crazy. fucked up, I didn't get the level 2. There you go. If you really know that they're gonna press a button, you can do stuff like that. You can go into climax, you can also do... Hold on. Oops. This is real specific, of course. Or button. Not sure. But yeah, everyone will have their own, you know, their own... solutions. And so on. So the guard cancel rolls in that aspect are way more safe because come mid screen. So if I do that and it guard cancel rolls, so you go back on block. Block and then, yeah, exactly. Oops. Okay, completely safe. Completely safe. So you don't really have to think what like the attacker can do if they're reading that. It's just chasing that, but they're not going to have you know, any frame advantage. So on, just positioning. So on the attack, those are the things you do. So it's high, low, throws, delayed buttons, common throws, or overheads. Now everything has a counter, so you can't really think, oh, now it's my turn and they can do shit. Because you can do that, they can block, and then they can press a button because you are trying to delay, right, and they're gonna catch you. Or you're trying to throw them and they press a button, you eat a full combo. You're trying to, I don't know, force the block stun and they're just gonna run like guard cancel away. So if I do guard cancel at the second hit, not at the first. Yeah, exactly. So you know, I'll whiff the overhead and they can punish or whatever, they're gonna run away and so on. Now what this is interesting is pretty much any of the options aside the throw, and for some characters there's also the throw, because they can go into a common throw and then they can convert. For example, Maxima can do it. He has the running grab and then goes into supers, into climax or whatever. So all of these options have a follow-up. So if you start there, you got this. If you start high, of course you're gonna have your full jumping combo. If you delay a button, then you can have an extension, and so on and so on. So it's a matter really of rotating these options. However, in this game, defense, as I said, is strong because of the whole light things, and they have TPs and so on. Every character has their own. What you need to do, and what you need to learn as an attacker, is to hit confirm stuff. So another thing, for example, if I jump, right, and you put a button out, I can delay, but I can also do that. Block the first. Sorry. So you know, go low. And so on. So yeah, I was saying, what you need to learn is to fully convert on everything. So what I started to do as soon as I started with this game was to get down in the training mode, find that the most optimized combo for everything and just rinse it. So that means, for example, my low is now, depending on the position, because right now I'm using him as a second. This is my old point character opening, so on. But this is a lot of damage. My opening without bars is that one. On some characters, I don't know if they fixed it, you can have... Come on. Yeah, you get that. Or whatever. So on. So for each opening, you should be like pretty much trying to hit confirm. So I got I. Was I blocked? And then you start. What do I do if I was blocked? Do I delay a button? Do I throw them? Do I go low? Do I go back and wait for a whiff punish in case they press a button? So this is your wheel of possibilities. But from each situation, you should be able to convert if anything goes as you're expecting it to go. So if you get a jump in, if you get a low, and so on. And that's a lot of the KOF attack, aggression, and so on. One other thing is space control. This works defensively, as we've seen last time, you know, these buttons and so on, but works offensively as well. Because if I... should probably swap positions, hold on. That's alright. Can you pause when I'm doing that? Pause again. Yeah, that's why it's hard. But yeah, press triangle. So see, all that space is occupied right now by my extended hand. Now it's a stupid range because I'm too high there. But generally you'd be at, yeah, exactly, at this height, which is a pretty good place to be. However, if you were right now, let's say 2 steps forward, what would you do to counter that? So you could DP, and that's a situation, but I think you trade. Of course, depends on the timing and on the range. Another thing that you could do is crouching medium punch, crouching C or crouching D, especially crouching D because it goes under it. So all these buttons that you use to occupy space actually have a weakness because they're... See? You eat my feet. And so that's a high. And yes, you're occupying a lot of space, but your low is weak here. So how do you change that? So if you're in this situation, last time you got fucked up like that, as an attacker you do that. Right? Because it changes. There's two approaches in the air. This is what is called a hair-to-air button, which is different than air-to-air in Street Fighter. In Street Fighter, yes, it works kind of this way, but in Street Fighter, it's, I would say, harder to go air-to-air and control space, and it doesn't lead to anything. If I come to read this, right, at a certain places, like especially, for example, here, jump at me and press a button. Oops. Go on the other side. Might be late. Yeah, but you get the idea, that works. So, it's not just a question of controlling the air, it's also getting the reward for it. That also would have worked. Try again. Oops, go back. Ah, go again. So yeah, that's the idea. As I was saying, so you're trying to occupy the space there, because you would like jumping CD into level 2 or whatever, pretty free, pretty riskless, and so on. However, they run at you. Do you have air to air? I think yours is CD as well. That could be, actually it could be air to ground. Try and jump at me and do it again. Yeah, that's air to ground. Jumping D. Jumping C. Yeah, jumping C is your air to air. It looks pretty shitty, but... So, you know, that's the idea. You run at people because you're expecting that. And then you convert into big numbers. Of course, this is not optimized, but whatever, you get the idea. So, as I said, what you do to change... For example, you could do jumping... B? Show me your jumping B. Is that jumping B? Oh shit. Come at me. Yeah, that still works. Probably a shitty range. But you know, I will not be able to do crushing B under it. So, that's kind of your air-to-air space control. However, that doesn't mean that you should only jump to attack. For example, Ryo has a good sweep. If I do that, right? Oops, sorry. If you block there, then I can mix it up. And it's safe on block, so whatever. And it leads to a soft knockdown, which means almost guaranteed pressure. And so on. Moreover, depending on the character, this is a game where running at somebody, pressing a button and going into max is not a stupid idea. Even though in another game would be, because you're losing a bar pretty much. But if I do that, it's completely legit. Because even if you block it, even if you read it, right, I'm still plus. If we jump, I'll do it again as soon as the bar is depleted. You jump as soon as you block it. Like, I throw the button, I activate max and you jump, okay? See? I'm like minus one maybe? So, who cares? Depending on the buttons, of course. If I am Chang, I'm not gonna press button on Yoni, for example. But, you know, you get the idea. So, you can get decent pressure sometimes, depending on the button and on the character. And also, you can occupy space. So, if I do that, I have plenty of time to see. If it hits, I press the buttons and I confirm. If it doesn't, I just let it go. Because most of the time, stuff is not punishable. Like Yori standing D, Benimaru standing D, whatever other character, right? I can't remember, but Orim is standing D as well. Oh yeah. Moreover, our knockdown are precious because this is not our knockdown. This is our knockdown because you can do safe jump. Oops, I fucked up. Try and wake up DP. Ah, fuck it. Sorry. Oops. Yeah, well, that was super. Let's try again. And that's, you know, if you don't have bar, if you have bars, then you go into super, blah, 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 blah. So yeah, those are valuable because that's your guaranteed pressure. And if they roll away, you have option selects as well. So roll back. You can option select runs. Of course, they can roll forward. But in that case, yes, it's not the greatest because you lose pressure. But most of the time, you're safe. See? So, and you can always read it. So it's about reading your opponent. Because if I know that you're gonna jump forward, roll forward. Oops, sorry. So yeah, there are option selects. Also, I think you can negate completely the roll with some option selects. Like, let me try this. So see, you just get them with the throw, and I think you can do it with the normal throw as well. And it's in the same position. And then you will confirm if you get a hit instead of the throw, right? So yeah, that's a thing as well. One other thing to know is air to air that don't knock down, because this does knock down, right? But if you jump at me and I do, I will have the frame advantage there, unless you come and grab because you're invincible, or you're super because you're invincible. But in a situation where you cannot be invincible, then you know that your opponent is forced to throw, forced to block, sorry. And then you can set your own pace, depending on what you want. What else? Yeah, we talked about buttons into delayed buttons for frame traps. Option selects, of course. So, the option selects are different in this game. Are many. I only know few because I'm learning myself this game. So it's not that I'm very advanced. I'm nowhere as advanced as I was in other games. But let's go back to the situation. So jump, jump D, right? That's your safe jump here. And if they roll away, then the throw should come out. You just do forward throw or back throw. See? if they roll away, the roll is not grab invincible, so you can just grab them as soon as they wake up. Oops, I fucked up. So this is just like punch throw or kick throw, depending on what you want. Let's say that, for example, right? Come here, where I am, and then I'll go on the other side. So I throw you, no, the other way. For some reason, right? Go on the other side. You're doing your strings at me, and I gotta grab. Oh, fucked up again. This is smarter than having how do you say, a hard knockdown throw in some situations, because the hard knockdown throw, yes, leaves her there, but anything goes wrong, you're pressing me in the corner. However, if you have that situation, yes, it's a soft knockdown, so you'll see, you can recover that, go on the other side. But still, you're in the corner and I'm not. So that in there comes your positioning. One other thing that you can do, come mid-screen. When you knock somebody down, oh sorry, this is not power. You can option select a run. So there you didn't see a run, but a run was there. So what you do is when you jump onto them, before your jumping D or jumping D or whatever button you use connects, you input a forward dash, and that will they will be followed by the run, and then it's. You have all the time in the world, really, literally, to confirm. Oh, for some reason I fucked up my safe jump. You can negate the ropes. One other thing that you can do, but this is spacing and character dependent. If they roll away, right? This doesn't work great with the Ryo because his CD is short. However, if we go and character select and we pick Robert, you'll see the difference because Robert goes, you know, door kicker, yeah. And just goes in with his old foot. So he can option select people with the standing CD. So what you do is you jump. You jump D in that situation, and then you press CD while D is out, so you don't get a double input. Okay, give me control. Thank you. So, okay, oops, sorry. Oh, come on. So I've not done this one. I'll probably need the jump in. Yeah, no, it's not a hard knockdown then. Yes, probably not. Was it? Yeah, seems a hard knockdown. Okay, so. Trying to think. Oh, this is also. It's just like there's nothing that leaves him. But it doesn't only work on hard knockdown. So we could do, for example, right? Try to recover for that. This you can recover, like roll. That's, of course, you can do without option selecting anything. Right, see? If you want maybe a meaty. Oops, sorry. That's a bit too. In this case, you have to release. Because you like it. No. But yeah, in a situation where you have a hard knockdown, at the moment I don't. This is a situation. You get that. Oh no, I fucked up. So the CD, however, doesn't doesn't autocorrect. So that means if you're in this situation, you're always option selecting back. If you want to option select a forward roll, you have to wait a little bit. So you have to read it, because that way, basically what you're telling the game is, right, I'm going front and I'm putting my option select for front because I'm reading back. However, if you delay, you're basically inputting your option select the time in which the game swaps the side by itself. There's auto turn. So let's say that you roll the forward or wake up here, right? See, I waited, but if you come back, if I don't wait and we do the same thing, that was too fast for me. That's all too slow for me. Nah, still too slow again. His option select, we see these are. See, this happens, and then you're out. And potentially, you could even punish depending on the character. So, in this situation, you can force an offense on the opponent. However, what the opponent can do, if in a situation where he knows that you can option select them, and then it's really hard for you to do something about it, there are solutions, of course, but let's say they were in the same situation as before, right? Knowing what you know about the game now, right? The sequence is there, and then I do jumping D, and I will option select that roll. So you know that I'm so good with option selects that I showed you 20 times that I never missed it, right? If you're in this, which is not the case, of course, absolutely not the case, but if you're in that situation, what would you do with how much you know about the game now? I'm sorry. Yeah, and what can you do with the block? Because if you block, like block, then you might hit a throw. What do you do with the block? If you know that the next mix-up will kill you and you have bars, what do you do? No, you block, you have blocked this jumping everything. Yeah, that could be a thing. But if you're, yeah, that's way better. And how do you think the attacker could adjust to that? See, I've option select, the scenario is I've option selected you 20 times, and now I've seen that you have done that, right? And you went away. How do you think on the next knockdown, where we have this, sorry again, better get it. No, get it right now. No, get it by the DP into the super. This is my adjustment, right? Or if you're blocking high, depending on how you're blocking, of course, because you're blocking high, because this was my first thing, right? So, and so on, whatever you want, right? So that's how you're adjusting. That's how the defense and the offense are talking to each other, we say. So in that situation, especially in the corner, is oppressive for the defender. And that's why, and also the game kind of rewards the attacker, the hard knockdown, the continued pressure. It's a very attack-based game. It rewards the offense as well, because if you go back at the other video I saw, the defender always builds more meter. So if you're blocking, you're actually building more meter than the one that is attacking. However, there's a guard meter there, so don't forget that. But yeah, I was saying, so in this situation, I have the advantage. If you wake up DP there, I can actually probably safe jump. So go back. Oh, that's not a safe jump. Try again. I don't know the safe jump of Robert yet. But yeah, it's a fake. It's a good fake. You probably do it. So, so those are kind of the dynamics of the attack as well. One other thing is less used, I would say. But oh, come on. Oh. Let's say that you're blocking this, right? And then you know that if I do the jump at the standing B, is that I'm actually gonna be. It's probable that you can interrupt me. Yeah, before the standing B. Probably not. Yeah, but there are some situations in which I fall short. Try standing B. Show me your standing B. Could be. Or standing A. Standing A, probably. No? Okay. See? If I do... Let's say that I'm doing 4. I would not do 4, but... But yeah, the situation where the enemy is gonna press a button. See? That's another thing. Blowbacks in neutral are not that common, but I think it's gonna be quite strong once the game evolves. Because what I like a lot about this game is it's still a KOF. It's very different from the other KOFs. Because in other KOFs it's way more dominant, the fact that you jump and you jump. And you jump, you kind of reach people, right? So, and so on, and then go low, blah, 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 blah. In this game, there's also a little bit of neutral with the old max and the things, and so on. So I think it will evolve where people will blow up fake strings. So, for example, right, if you're on Ultra Street Fighter 4, not sure if in 5 is, but in 4, if you're playing Ryu or you do crouching medium kick into fireball and your max range, people can actually get through it.
Yeah.
Because it's not a true block tree. Same here, if I do. Oh, oops. Try and reversal super after the third crouching light kick. Level 2. You're gonna have something, I don't know what you have. It's probably hard. Yeah, even that. See, so you started with something, didn't eat because it's slow and blah blah blah. But if you had probably the Hadouken super, can you try it? You know that?
Yeah,
I'll try. Oh, sorry. But yeah, strings that are not true, the attacker could just walk back and bait. The only time. Okay. Yeah, that could be a thing. So yeah, I know they're gonna do that, right? I stop. Yeah, but you get the whole thing. So. I think this game will have a little bit of Street Fighter footsies in there as well. Because the whiff punishes, ground to ground, are there. They're just different because in Street Fighter what happens is there's like one, two, few characters, probably 4 with common movements. Like, you know, the coverage just teleports around, Rolento rolls, Fuerte runs and so on. Here everyone is a run. So it's kind of harder to see the whole, you know, I'll whiff the button, they're gonna press a button and fuck me up. Because everyone can just run in range. They're not walking and misjudging the range, they're just running in. So, a little bit less, but I think at some point, untrue block string are gonna be very important. Now, if you saw my rage against the geese yesterday night, there was a point in which I was like, finally, he did crouching D into fireball. So I did that into Repuken, right? And what I did was go through it with this one, with the level 2. Because it's invincible. So I think the attack is gonna be strong in this game, but there are gonna be ways around it. However, there's gonna be like, you know, baits and counter baits and so on. So if you want to get good fast in this game, I would say, the first thing you do is you go in training mode, you pick every situation. So the situations are openers from high, so that would be your jump in, right? So that's my one bar BNB opening from high. Actually, it's with punch, so... come on. This one. Probably EX into that. For every situation, you need to find the best way to get damage. So you go... jump high, meterless. So what do you get meterless? For example, my biggest combo, meterless... Oh, shit, shit. If I'm not in the corner, because you have some in the corner that extend. So, for example, come here. Mine is... this one, right? But if I'm in the corner, he actually changes, because the dive kick gives me one more point of juggle. So that would be... right? And that's my eye opener. However, what happens if it's a low? The potential for Robert has been killed in the lows. Because first you did... well, you still do... oh, come on. That's your maximum capacity as well. However, sometimes you're like, yeah, I'm gonna be minus 2 there on it, on the Tatsu. Either minus 2 or minus 1, I can't remember. And some super grabs can actually punish it on it, which is quite funny. So you might want something like that. No, this doesn't work actually. One, whatever. Or you might want, and you get a soft knockdown. To, you know, just come mid screen. Oops, again. You roll back. Sorry. Probably I cannot chase you there, but. I think it's not a hard knockdown, but it might be a mistake. Also, not really reliable on this art box. Okay, got it. Let me try and recover. Probably late. Is this a hard knockdown? We saw it before, it wasn't, right? Oh, maybe it was the other one, hold on. Because I was doing this one, right? Oh, okay. Okay, so yeah, for example, you're like, oh, minus 2 on it. Maybe I can do it against, I don't know, Rio. Rio doesn't have a common grab, right? But if I'm against Ralph, or Clark, or Chang, Maxima, KOD, whoever has the common grabs that are very, very fast. Yuri has a 2-frame, for example. So I wouldn't close my BMB with this or with the yeah. Let's try this actually. Too slow. But yeah. So even if you're not punishable, you're still minus. So, oops. Why don't you get a hard knockdown, right? And so on. So yeah, whatever, we were talking about that. Oh yeah, so I was saying, your real homework as a fighting game player is, go home, you're like, okay, this is my eye opener, right? This, and so on. This is my low without bars, right? And then you pick all of the ones that are possible. If you don't know, of course, you're gonna read guides or find videos and so on. And I'll show you mine. This is for Robert and this is the 2.0. So just to give you an idea, you can look here. So this is my IBMBs, right? Well, I put the stun, but the stun is really not that important unless you're playing characters like Vanessa or Joe that are high stun. So jumping B, standing C, forward B, heavy Tatsu, and that's the one that I was telling you, mid-screen, and it looks like this, but you're minus there. Or you lose 4 damage, which is not much, it's probably, it's very stupid. Right. Why is it done more damage? Oh no, 2 CC. Yeah, that's the damage. So yeah. And that's mid-screen. Then you have corner only, which is the one that I showed you. Oops, sorry. Yeah. And so on, right? 306 damage, and so on. 316 damage. Then you have lows. Now, this is what I have, because I have it, if you see. This is the highest damage. But then sometimes, there might be something that I need to remember. For example, here, I didn't write that this is a hard knockdown. Which is valuable. It's very valuable. So, if I know that, like... for example, my opponent has 300 damage left, right? And I land crushing B, like Tatsu. And then he grabs me, because this is, if it's unsafe. Let's say it's unsafe, I don't remember, but let's say it's unsafe, he grabs me, he converts into Super, he has the bars for Climax, I'm dead. Right? Probably not a good idea to go there. So you're like, oh, I will go into crushing B, standing A, heavy short you. You recover. Right, you guess right, maybe, I don't know, I jump high because I want to get your button, like you do, I would do, I jump high, and you wake up Climax or whatever you have, right? And I'm done, and I'm dead. So, at that point, you're choosing a mix-up with more risk for not a guaranteed kill. None of these ones will kill an opponent with 300 damage left, right? So, why don't I sacrifice, what is it, 11, 13 damage, whatever it is, instead of doing that, oops, sorry, given of course that it's, safe jump, they wake up with super, I block, safe jump, they wake up with common grab without armor, because if they have armor, sometimes you can get fucked up. So you safe jump, and they wake up with common grab, you hit them and you confirm. Safe jump, they decide to roll away, you option select on the other side or on that side, depending on where, or throw them. So at that point, you're forcing the situation, you're sacrificing 13, 14 damage for forcing the situation into the next mix-up. Because you know that the next mix-up is the one that counts. They have 300, you have 400, 500 left. So that's the situation, right? That's how you have to think as an attacker. What else? Yeah, that's pretty much how this works. However, if you can get the kill in this game, especially with the later characters, so if you play Anchor against Anchor, or you're playing your first character against Anchor, throw the bars every time. Don't save the bar unless you know, if you're like 5% against full bars, right, and you have 2 bars, and there's 50 seconds left at the end of your super, then maybe not a good idea to do it, because they will recover half of it, and you still have lost 2 bars. Right, so that's the system that comes into play, the one that I was talking about in the last video. So if you're in the situation where on the next wake up they're gonna chip you out, maybe it's not that good to invest those many bars, because then your anchor comes in, they might have bars still, they'll be sitting on 5, and that means one touch into 70-80-90% with some characters. Yamazaki does huge amount of damage. And you're gonna be with the next characters that cannot convert into damage. So at that point you're playing a 3 mix-up against 1 mix-up and a half game. So that's how you think as well. And trying to think what else. Oh, common grabs. Not this one, because this one is quite slow. But for example, if you go character select and we go to Yuri. Yuri has a very fast common grab. Now this is not a super common grab, which is where you're betting more, right? But common grabs in this game can blow up safe jumps if they're not like absolutely precise safe jumps, because some of them have one frame start, like tongue has a one frame start, a common grab. You need to give me commands, because the game for some reason doesn't remember it. So yeah, for example, you do your BMB, whatever it is, right? And then you jump over me and press a button. Knock me down, jump on me and press a button. Oh, that was way too high. Yeah, they need to be a little bit lower. See? And then you get your guaranteed pressure and so on. However, yes, if I do this, and you wake up with common grab, that happens. And there, yeah, exactly. However, what happens then? Because, you know, it's always a game of counters, it's always a game of thinking what is the next level. So, I do that, right? Fucked up. Again. Right? Or, instead of doing that, hold on, on the other side, I don't do the common dive kick, I'll still give a good jump. See, because I was airborne. Like, even if you absorbed my kick, then I was airborne. If I'm too low, that one. But you know, it's always a matter of baiting. Again. Into max, into whatever. Of course, depends by the whiff motion of the common grab. So if I was to do that against Yuri, like same sequence, right? But I throw the fireball and then I go down and let's say that she has armor. She doesn't have armor, but and then I go down. Yuri recovers before me and then does that. So I like the layers. I was in Manchester last time. I was playing Ultra, and I went to infernoKong, which is the guy that won Ice Spotting, and he was talking about lasagna mix-up. Lasagna mix-ups. And I just started laughing because I just couldn't understand the fuck he was talking about. But then he said to me, lasagna is in layers, right? So you're at this layer and you're showing me this. And then I learn, and then we go deeper. To the point where you know right now that I can bait you, and you're like, oh, I'm gonna get out of there. I'm gonna just roll away, right? See? So that's how it evolves. And that's when the game becomes entertaining and becomes fun and motivating to play. That's what you see top 8s of big tournaments and stuff like that. So that's why I like it. I'm trying to think what else I can talk about in... Yes, this is also important. More on the defensive side rather than the attacking side, but... See, for example, when there's a long recovery button, Ryo overhead or mature. See how mature goes the whole record. Can you pick mature? She goes all like crouching light punch into the whole three Rekkas. If you know, most people will not do it. But let's say that you find somebody stupid enough to do the whole Rekka over and over again and don't stop. So you're attacking, you're managing to have your pressure, but they sneak their crouching light punch in there and then just go Rekka, right? Some characters actually cannot punish it. I think I cannot punish the second Rekka, I can punish the third. So you do crouching light punch, Rekka, right? This is a lot of time she's active doing something. So let's say that the scenario is I'll jump D on you, right? You block, and I am trying to delay a button because I've seen that you press the buttons, but you don't. Like, you do press the button, and you press it very early, and I'm fucked up, right? So I have to block. And that's the situation. You're like, oh, free chip, she's not punishable. She is at the third rack, but let's say she stops. So she's not punishable. What the fuck? This should be my turn, right? So what you do is... Like, if she continues, you know, you just run back. You lose a bar, which sucks, to be honest. but you get the punish, and then you can go into, you know, the whole art knockdown thing. Actually, I don't think you can combo that. Is it combo? Hold on. Six was... come here. I can't see. Yeah, five, so yeah. So, you know, art knockdown into rinse and repeat, safe jump, aggression, blah blah blah, mix up and so on. So, when you see that something is really really good, but also has a lot of frames of animation, like lasts a lot on screen, always remember they can roll back, like roll forward and punish them. Or back, depending on something, like depending on what they do. Do the whole Rekka thing. See? Of course, like, a good player will stop and not get caught, but... so yeah, I think for now, let's call this, like, level 1 attack. Maybe we'll do level 2 if I think about somebody or something else, but I think we have some material for people to listen to. So that's the end of our recording.